Do you know which type of Crohn's disease you have? And did you know there are in fact 6 different types of Crohn's disease? If the answer to those questions were no, then stick around as I'll explain the different types of Crohn's disease that you may possibly have. Welcome back to my channel, the best place for Crohn's and colitis tips, tricks, and information. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a video. And if you want to join an exclusive community of people who receive my personal tips, tricks, and free stuff about living with Crohn's and colitis, make sure you sign up to my newsletter by visiting the link in the description box below. Now, Crohn's disease can affect anywhere from the mouth to your anus, and depending on which areas of your digestive tract it is found in, will determine the type of Crohn's disease you have. So I'll go through this chronologically so it's easier to understand. Number one is oral Crohn's disease, or you may have heard of it being called orofacial granulomatosis. Oral Crohn's disease is rare, but it's most likely to occur in children. And what you may find if you are in a flare is that you develop mouth ulcers, swollen lips, or even get fissures around the mouth. These can sometimes be caused by nutritional deficiencies, so if you're low on iron, folic acid, or vitamin B12, but in general, it's a sign of oral Crohn's disease. Number two is called gastroduodenal Crohn's disease, and this refers to your esophagus, stomach, and duodenum being affected with Crohn's disease. The main symptoms that you may find if you do have this type of Crohn's disease is you get a lot of indigestion, feel like you're going to be sick, or even vomit, along with no appetite, which is why you lose so much weight. This can also make you more likely to be anemic, as you may not feel like eating and not getting the essential nutrients that your body needs. Number three is small bowel Crohn's disease. The usual symptoms of small bowel Crohn's disease is diarrhea, anemia, weight loss, and pain, as this involves Crohn's disease affecting your small intestine, so your duodenum, jejunum, and ileum. Number four is what is known as terminal ileal and ileocecal Crohn's disease. So the last portion of your small intestine is called the ileum, or the terminal ileum, and it attaches to the first part of your large intestine, which is known as the cecum. Crohn's disease affecting these portions is known as terminal ileal or ileocecal Crohn's disease. Number five is colonic Crohn's disease, and this is Crohn's disease of the large intestine. It's actually one of the most common forms of Crohn's disease, and is sometimes known as Crohn's colitis, but it's not the same or shouldn't be confused with ulcerative colitis. If you want to know the difference between Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, check out this video and you can find the link in the description box below. Number six is perianal Crohn's disease, which affects the anus. And people usually start to notice this type of Crohn's disease because this is where symptoms like fissures, skin tags, fistulas, and abscesses usually occur before any intestinal symptoms develop. And there you have it, the 6 types of Crohn's disease. Now, I should mention that you can have more than one type of Crohn's disease at one point, and they're not really called types, but are given specific names to make it easier to know which type of Crohn's disease that you have. And it also helps identify which part of your digestive tract is affected with Crohn's. Now make sure you check out these videos for more useful tips, tricks, and information for Crohn's and colitis. Hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified every time I post a video, as well as leaving a like and a comment if you enjoyed this video and found it useful. And I can't wait to see you all in the next episode.